that with the film. Notice in the film that you guys filmed in your hometown, Grundy, Virginia.
That's
and
right.
a little bit in Bristol, Tennessee. Tell me how that was filming back in your hometown.
Oh, it was amazing. It was so cool coming back to reconnect with a lot of people I hadn't seen in 25 years. So, very fun. When I got the script, I knew that it needed to be a place that was blue-collar, salt of the earth, God-fearing, hard-working people. That's what was called for, literally written on the page. And it was initially set in rural Pennsylvania, but I had a bright idea to actually bring it back to my hometown. You know, not unlike most people who would read the script, when I read it, I pictured in my mind's eye the places that I was most familiar with. So when I saw the railroad tracks, I pictured in my head the railroad tracks where I grew up. The diner was the diner that I knew best. And so I presented this idea to the writer, director, and the other producers to come back to Virginia and Tennessee to shoot this. They obliged, and cut to a year later, here we are. It's pretty amazing.
Wonderful. Well, I've heard the comparison of this movie is kind of a blend between A Wonderful Life and Scrooge. Can you tell me where your inspiration comes from, your character, Matthew Payton?
Yeah. Well, strangely enough, perhaps a bit of irony or maybe even prophecy, Billy wrote this script 20 years ago and obviously didn't know me at all. And the character of Matthew Payton that I play really parallels my own life in a very strange way. Both of my parents have passed, and this is a 40-year-old guy, you'll find out in the movie, who's lost his parents. His parents were business leaders in the community, as was his grandfather. Same boat for me, same thing. And, you know, it's a bit of an everyman journey of this character where he has to ask big questions at some point in his life. He has to ask questions about faith and morality and what he really believes. And he goes on this kind of a trek to figure that out. And through really the unlikeliest of heroes in this little African-American boy who finds him and befriends him and just encourages him, he comes to faith in the film to really ask those big questions. What is life all about? And at Christmas time, thankfully, we can't get away from Jesus, and so the movie is about Christmas, and that's infused all through the picture, and I'm really proud of it.
Wonderful. Well, tell me what some of your, I think this is going to be a classic Christmas film. Tell me what your favorite classic Christmas film is.
Oh, well, it has to be It's a Wonderful Life.
Perfect.
And full disclosure, Billy Dixon, when he was writing the movie, he infused bits and pieces of It's a Wonderful Life all through it. In fact, Isaac's character is Clarence Joseph.
Yes.
It's in the movie.
Yes.
And so, as you see it, if you know the movie, you'll see Easter eggs all throughout.
Nice. So, what kind of message do you want the viewers to get out of this? And tell me what's next for you.
Yeah. Well, the message really is a message of hope. And it's a message that despite how bad things are, or how bad you think they are, how much worse things are you think are going to get, number one, there's always hope. There's always hope on the other side of that. And secondly, no matter what station in life you are, there's always someone worse off. So you can reach back and help somebody else. And what's next for me is a couple of projects. I'm doing a movie called An American Game, which is a story of baseball during the Civil War. And I have another film based on a Christian book called Desolate Beauty.
Well, thank you so much for speaking with me today.
Thank you so much.